this is a quick video just to teach your dog how to put a collar on. And by a collar, it can be a standard collar, a slip lead, whether that's just a piece of rope or a proper slip lead, and also a muzzle. These things are essential safety things for your dog. So in emergency situations, if your dog's lost, the ability for somebody to come up and your dog allow them to do that, put a slip lead over them, or a muzzle, whether you like them or not, they are essential. If your dog's injured and goes to a vet and is in pain, the vet is more than likely going to put a muzzle on it. So the quicker that dog will accept the muzzle with the less stress, the better its chances are. If your dog becomes lost, if you come upon a stray dog, if they're taught, or an injured dog, getting this on. So if we just take it back to your dog, it makes it much easier for you to get a collar on. It makes it easy for you to get a muzzle on if you need it. It makes it easy for you to get a slip lead on if you need it, if your dog escapes or gets injured or anything like that. So potentially this is a life-saving command. You simply have the dog sit. I have a nice loose lead like this, either a slip lead or I often use just a piece of rope that's formed and slipped. And I just lure the dog through it.
Good boy.
I have it big enough that it easily goes over the head. I don't want it on here, so we're in there having a strain and a bite, because you're just going to make your dog anxious. It's not going to want to put its head through it. So the loop's nice and big, and you just lure the dog through. Let him chew on the treat, but don't let him have it until it's over, and then you let him take it. So again, have it so it's nice and big, lure him through, put it over, let the treat go,
pray. Good boy.
Once he's got that down pat, you just move up to the next step, which is just giving it a command.
Fella. Good boy.
And I continue that again, nice and calm, nice and gentle, nice and clear.
Fella. Good boy.
And again, it's good boy once the collar's on him.
Koji, collar, good boy.
Once you've got to that, it's a point of picking it up and going to your next point. Now I have no treat, collar, and I expect him just to do that little,
good boy,
little head tilt to help me on.
Collar, good boy.
Normally I don't have treats in my hand, only when I first trained him. So now that he can smell them on me, he's expecting them. And generally he won't get treats for his collar.
Good boy.
And this is something that's done every time we get him out of his crate. He sits in his crate, he waits, he gets the command collar. He puts his head forward and the collar goes on. So every time this comes on, that's what he's got to do. I've brought dogs back that wouldn't come back by simply saying the word collar. And they've come up to get their collar on because they think that's a good thing, and they often would get a treat for it. So sometimes it actually helps with a recall. And also when you're doing collar work, the other important thing is when I put a collar on or a lead on or call a dog to me, I don't automatically just put it on, lead it away and end its play. One of your training things should be to put it on, let it go free. They can go play, you bring them back. So that just keeps them going. And it's the same with one of these collars. Collar. There he tilts his head forward. That makes me very easy, even down at his level. I'm over the top of the dog. This is a clip end, doesn't matter. The leather collars that we use as well, same thing. But I can separate his fur, it doesn't get caught. It's very easy to get to. Get a lead on it, bang, good boy. All right, so exactly the same principle as that. I come underneath him, collar, I give the command, he tilts his head. So your best bet to do this one first is a good one, because you get that, easy to get that head tilt. Ah, collar, head, collar, good. And then just go from there. Now, this is a muzzle. Now, I haven't actually trained him with a muzzle yet. I've been a bit slack. So this will be all new to him. But it doesn't take a dog long. Again, you just bring the treat in through it.
Yes, good boy.
And as soon as they put their head in to eat the treat, praise it, release it.
Yes, good boy.
So you're watching this for the first time.
Yes, good boy.
And as soon as he gets the hang of that, I add a command.
Muzzle. Yes, good boy.
Koji, muzzle.
Yes.
And it's just a matter of...
Muzzle.
Yes. He's already got the idea from the leads. So it's just an extension of that, which makes it...
Muzzle.
Really simple. And then from there, I keep it on just a little bit longer. So now... I just hold the treat and I make him chew it, and now it's on there longer.
Good boy.
And I just keep extending that. I'll hold the treat a little longer.
Good boy, yes.
And he'll keep his head in there.
Yes. Good boy.
And so as you can see, I'm already building up time, and you just continue that until
muzzle.
So the dog is really comfortable. It helps if you hold it. So you'll just continue along this line for the muzzle. Muzzle.
Yes.
So you can see he's starting to put his head in there before the treat now. So I'll continue practicing this with him, because this is essential for us when we're on the road and we're in areas where there are baits. And like I said, it'll also be essential if they need to go to a vet and get treatment and need a muzzle for that. So you just continue along that way, build up time, and then eventually it goes on. And then again, you feed him through that short periods on until he gets more comfortable, and then they'll just wear it. So I hope that helps. Thank you.